ओके सो हेलो एंड वेलकम एवरीवन टू द यूट्यूब चैनल ऑफ इन्फिनिटी लर्न बाय श्री चैतन्य एंड हियर आई एम वंस अगेन विथ यू टू डिस्कस द सल्यूशन ऑफ द वीकेंड एलटीसी टेस्ट. ओके सो लेट्स बिगिन विद द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन. अ बॉडी ऑफ मास स्मॉल एम इज टेकन फ्रॉम अर्थ सर्फेस टू हाइट इक्वल टू ट्वाइस द रेडियस ऑफ द अर्थ. द चेंज इन पोटेंशियल एनर्जी इज सिंपल फॉर्मूला. हियर वी हैव अ सिंपल फॉर्मूला फॉर चेंज इन पोटेंशियल एनर्जी. रिमेंबर इट इज एम जी एच अपॉन वन प्लस एच बाय आर. क्लियर. नाउ इन दिस क्वेश्चन दे हैव ऑलरेडी गिवन दैट एच इज इक्वल्स टू टू आर. सो इफ यू पुट इट हियर, इफ यू पुट दिस वैल्यू हियर, यू विल से सर चेंज इन पोटेंशियल एनर्जी विल बिकम एम जी इंटू टू आर अपॉन वन प्लस टू आर अपॉन आर एंड योर आंसर विल बी टू बाय थ्री एम जी आर. गॉट इट. सो फोर्थ ऑप्शन इज करेक्ट. आर यू एबल टू अंडरस्टैंड दिस? सिंपल इट इज. ओके सो रिमेंबर दिस फॉर्मूला दैट एम जी एच अपॉन वन प्लस एच बाय आर गिव्स यू चेंज इन पोटेंशियल एनर्जी वेन यू टेक एन ऑब्जेक्ट फ्रॉम सर्फेस ऑफ अर्थ टू एनी हाइट एच. ओके फैंटास्टिक. नाउ सेकेंड क्वेश्चन. अ ट्रक ट्रैवलिंग ड्यू नॉर्थ. ओके फैंटास्टिक. अ ट्रक इज ट्रैवलिंग ड्यू नॉर्थ. सो इट्स इनिशियल वेलोसिटी इज 20 जे कैप. देन इट टर्न्स वेस्ट. वेस्ट इज वेयर हियर. दैट मीन्स विद द सेम स्पीड सो वेलोसिटी विल बी 20 माइनस आई कैप. दिस इज वी टू. सो वॉट दे आर आस्किंग इज वॉट इज द चेंज इन वेलोसिटी. सो चेंज इन वेलोसिटी विल बी वॉट? वेक्टर वी टू माइनस वेक्टर वी वन. सो इट विल बी 20 टाइम्स माइनस आई कैप माइनस 20 times j cap, right? So technically delta v vector will become 20 times minus i cap plus 20 times minus j cap. And if you really want to find out its magnitude, it's simple. 20 square plus 20 square under root. So change in velocity vector's magnitude will be 20 square plus 20 square under root, which will become 20 root 2. मीटर पर सेकेंड. नाउ विच ऑप्शन कंटेन्स 20 रूट टू? फर्स्ट एंड थर्ड. सेकेंड एंड फोर्थ आर रॉन्ग. नाउ नॉर्थ वेस्ट और साउथ वेस्ट. सो कैन यू सी दिस वेक्टर? लेट्स ड्रॉ दिस वेक्टर. 20 टाइम्स माइनस आई कैप प्लस 20 टाइम्स माइनस जे कैप. कैन यू सजेस्ट मी विच डायरेक्शन इज दिस? दिस इज साउथ वेस्ट डायरेक्शन. Okay, how do we know this? You can draw it in the beginning itself. This is north, this is west, this is east, this is south, right? So using this convention, you can say that it is southwest. So first option is correct. Phase difference between displacement and acceleration. See, what is displacement? Displacement is a sine omega t, right? What is acceleration? Minus a omega square sine omega t. Now, can I say that minus sin theta is sin of pi plus theta, right? So can I write acceleration as a omega square sin of omega t plus pi, which means that the phase difference between displacement and acceleration is pi. Got it? Fourth option is correct. Or always remember this thing, right? Now, two pendulums of length 121 centimeter, 100 centimeter start vibrating. Okay, so let's say time period T1 will be 2 pi root over L1 by G, right? So it will be somewhat, I can say that 2 pi into 121 centimeter upon 100 into G. So it will be 11 times 2 pi into 1 upon 100 g, or I can say like this, it will become 2 pi by 10 into 1 by root g, right? Just I'm saying something, let's see what is happening here. This is 11 and this will be pi by 5 root g. Got it? Let's say pi by 5 root g is t naught. Let's just assume. So it will be 11 t naught. Similarly, if I talk about T2, if I talk about the time period of the second pendulum, it will be 2 pi into root over 100 centimeter. Let's convert it into meter into g. So it will be how much? 10 times pi by 5 root g, which will be 10 t naught. Okay, fine. Do you understand? So we can say that time period of the longer pendulum is 11 t naught. Time period of shorter pendulum is 10 t naught. Now when they will meet again? So you just say, see, after 11 oscillations, so that means the time in which the first pendulum will cover 11 oscillations, okay, and the time in which it will cover 10 oscillations. So what we can do is, in such questions, we will say that when they meet once again, then n1 t1 must be equal to n2 t2. Right, n1 t1 must be equal to n2 t2. So we can say n1 is the number of oscillations of the first pendulum, n2 is the number of oscillations of the second pendulum. This is the time after which they will meet again, right? So you can say n1 into 11 t naught must be equal to n2 into 10 t naught, right? So I don't have enough space here, so I will take up this space. Okay, kindly pardon me. So it will become n1 by n2 is equals to 10 upon 11. Okay, that means after 10 oscillations, of the longer pendulum and 11 oscillations of the shorter pendulum, they will meet again. Okay, so this condition we have to apply and say. So we can say from here that n2 is coming out to be 11. That means after 11 oscillations or 11 complete rounds of the shorter pendulum, the pendulums are going to meet again, or the 10 oscillations of the longer pendulum. So if they would have asked you about how many vibrations longer pendulum has completed, then you will say 10. Shorter pendulum has completed, then you will say 11 here. Okay, clear? Let's move ahead. A satellite of mass small m is at a distance small r from the center of Earth. Another satellite, whenever they talk about satellite and its distance, and then they ask the time period, that means you have to use this equation. T square is directly proportional to r cube. You know this? T square is 4 pi square upon capital G m into r cube. R, capital R is the distance, right? Or I should say, okay, fine. Let it be. So we will say that the ratio of their time periods they want, right? So t1 is to t2 is r1 is to r2 whole to the power 3 by 2. Now r1 is what? Small r. r2 is what? 4r. Mass of the satellite doesn't matter here, right? Because this capital M is mass of the planet, not the mass of the satellite. So you should not worry that, sir, what will happen if the mass is also changing. If the mass of the planet changes, then there will be some changes here in the time period. But if the mass of the satellite is changing, then the time period of the satellite will not change. It depends only on the distance, right? 3 by 2. So I suppose it will become 1:8. Got it? First option is correct. Sixth question. The time period of oscillation of a simple pendulum on the surface of Earth is T. See, on the surface of Earth, it is T. So let's say T1 is 2 pi root over L by G. On the surface of Earth, it is G. T2 will be 2 pi root over L by... Now, just wait. We already know that. I will write it here. At any height on the surface of Earth, G dash is equals to G upon 1 plus h by r whole square. Okay, so you will say g dash at any height. So it will become t1 by t2 is equals to g dash by g under root. Now what is g dash? It is g upon 1 plus h by r whole square into 1 by g whole to the power 1 by 2. So t1 by t2 will become 1 upon 1 plus h by r whole square, and it is given that t1 is t and t2 is 4t, right? So it will become 1 by 4. Got it? So 1 plus h by r, sorry, this is square will be gone because we have already taken under root now. So 1 plus h by r is equals to 4, so h is equals to 3r. Got it? So third option is correct. Clear? Any doubt anywhere, just let me know. Clear. How can you let me know? It's a recording. Okay, in the chat box or in the comment section, you can let me know. Okay, so let's move ahead. And this one, okay, we know that what is the escape velocity of any satellite? 2gm by r under root. Okay, what is the orbital speed? Root gm by r. Okay, that means escape speed is root 2 times orbital speed, right? So they are asking what is the percentage increment in the velocity so that it will escape. You will say delta v by v naught into 100%. So what is delta v? It is ve minus v naught upon v naught into 100%. So it will be root 2 minus 1 v naught upon v naught into 100%. V naught cancel. Root 2 is 1.414. So 1.414 minus 1 is 0.414 into 100 is 41.4%. Which option is correct? Second option is correct. Got it? Let's move ahead. A thin rod of length L is bent to form a semicircle. Okay, a thin rod is bent to form a semicircle. Obviously, this semicircle will have radius r. So L is equals to pi r. So r is equals to L by pi. Now mass is capital M. What is the formula for the potential at the center? Because every point mass here is at the same distance. And every point mass will have potential dm minus gdm by r. Okay. And once you integrate, you will get the total potential at the center is minus g into capital M by r. Now what is r? L by pi. So minus pi g m by l. Second option is correct. Okay. Why? Because in the semicircular ring, the every point mass is at the same distance from the center and every point mass has a potential g into minus dm by r. Right. So when you integrate, you have to only integrate dm and integration of dm will become capital M. So the answer is minus g capital M by r and r is l by pi. So put it there and get the answer. Right. Ninth question. One of the rectangular components of the velocity is 80. What are the other components? Oh, very simple. See, whenever you talk about rectangular components, it is like this. Na? This is vector A, suppose. This is vector B. And you add them to get what? Vector R resultant. These are rectangular components. So obviously, R square is equals to A square plus B square. Got it? So if R is 80, whole square, it is 40 whole square plus b square. I suppose another component we can find it from here. It will be 80 square minus 40 square under root. So I guess 40 square can be taken out common. 4 minus 1, 3. So it will be 40 root 3. Okay. And 40 into root 3 is approximately 69.28. Got it? A body is projected from ground with the velocity, then its range is. See, here I will tell you to use this formula. The formula of range is ux into time of flight. Horizontal range, horizontal displacement is horizontal speed into time because acceleration is already zero along horizontal direction. Okay, fine. In case you don't know, I'll just tell you quickly one thing. Okay. Whenever we solve questions in two-dimensional motion, we solve by breaking the motion into two one dimensions. That means x axis we will separately analyze, y axis separately we analyze, right? So we say that displacement along x will be ux into t plus half into ax into t square. Now in projectile motion, ax is zero. So horizontal displacement becomes ux into time. Now we want complete range. So complete range means horizontal displacement in one complete time period. Now, what is time period? Everybody knows it is 2uy by g. So your formula will become 2ux uy by g. Now use this formula directly. Ux has been given 40, uy has been given 30. So 2 into 40 into 30 upon 10. 4, 2's are 8, 3's are 24, 10's are 240 meters. Got it? First option is right. 11. The total energy of the particle executing SHM is 48 joules. Okay, what is total energy? Half m omega square a square is 48 joules, right? This is total mechanical energy. Now, what is potential energy? It is half m omega square x square. Now, half of the displacement, they want potential energy. Half m omega square a by 2 whole square, that is total mechanical energy by 4. So, 48 by 4. So, potential energy is 12 joules. Got it? A particle has initial velocity and acceleration. Obviously, again, same thing. You will say, sir, vector v is equals to vector u plus vector a times time period. Time. Okay. So, u is how much? 3i cap plus 4j cap plus 10 times 0.4 i cap plus 0.3 j cap. Right. So, we can say that here, it will become vector v will be 7 i cap plus 7 j cap. And what is 7 i cap plus 7 j cap? Magnitude. It will be 7 root 2 meter per second. Got it? Now here, what is frequency? What is time period? Time period is 2 pi root over m by k. What is frequency? 1 upon time period. That is 1 by 2 pi root over k by m. From here we can say that frequency is directly proportional to root k. So f1 is to f2 is to f3 will be root k1 is to root k2 is to root k3. Now tell me, first case it is just k. Second case, both the springs are in series. So, k and k in series will become k by 2. Third case, they are in parallel. When the springs are in parallel, then we have to add them. K plus k, 2k. So, answer will be 1 is to 1 by root 2 is to root 2. Got it? See, when they are in parallel, then what happens? We say now 1 by k equivalent is equals to 1 by k 1 plus 1 by k 2 like this. So 1 by k plus 1 by k is 2 by k. So k 2 will be what? K by 2. Got it? That is why I placed it like that. Anyways, so let's move ahead. Densities of two planets are in the ratio. The radii, the ratio of the time period of simple pendulum. What is the time period of simple pendulum? 2 pi root over L by g. Time period is inversely proportional to root over g. Okay. Now what is g? G is gm by r square. Capital G by r square into density into 4 by 3 pi r cube. So small g will be capital G into 4 pi by 3 into rho into r. So from here you can say g is directly proportional to rho into r. Okay, so time period is inversely proportional to rho into r. So I guess from this you can take the ratio and figure out, right? So t1 by t2 will be root over rho 2 by rho 1 into r2 by r1. Now what is 2 is to 1 and 1 is to 3. Okay. So it will be 2 is to 1 into 1 is to 3 under root. So T1 by T2 will become 2 by 3 under root. Got it? Now, a wheel of circumference. Okay, fine. This is the wheel. Now it is rolling, right? It is rolling and it moves here. So if it is rolling, then this point is moving with velocity v. So they are asking half the revolution is over, right? Half the revolution, where will it go? If it is rolling, this point is at rest. This point moves with 2v and this point moves with v. Center moves with v. Okay. Clear? Now, they are asking the displacement of the point of contact. Now, in half the revolution, where will this point of contact go? See, we just, let's do one thing. Let's understand a very simple logic. See, this is your point of contact right now. Let's say A. So two things are happening, pure rotation and translation both. So if half the rotation is completed, definitely A will reach the topmost point here. That means right now A is here. Okay, A has gone to this point. Okay, now how much it has moved forward? So you will say, sir, how much it has moved forward, then see, because it is rolling, and not slipping. So we will say the distance it has moved forward will be the circumference, suppose it covers half the revolution. So the distance moved in half the revolution will be pi r. Okay. So the center has moved this distance. How much? Pi r. And where is the point A? Here at this height. 2r. So we will say the overall displacement of A is this. Okay. So you will say, sir, overall displacement will be 2r whole square plus pi r whole square whole to the power 1 by 2. Now, one more thing, we all know that circumference is 2 pi r. So circumference is, sorry, then radius is c upon 2 pi. Okay, so you will say 4 plus pi square into 4 plus pi square whole to the power under root into r, you can take out r square, you can take out common, it is c by 2 pi. So c by 2 pi into 4 plus pi square under root, I guess we can put 2 pi and inside also. So we will get 1 by pi square plus 1 by 4 under root. So which option is correct? Okay, first option, right? Got it? See, it is not slipping now. Since it is not slipping, so we will say that this center will exactly cover the same distance. See, let me tell you. The center is moving with V. In short, suppose if you have doubt, I can explain. See, the center is moving with V. Okay. And during rolling, V equals to R omega. Yes. Very good. Fine. V equals to R omega. So, we can say that omega is 2 pi upon time period. Right. Very good. So, V is equals to 2 pi R upon time period. Now, they are saying what is the distance covered in half of time period. So, we will say delta x is v into t by 2. Okay. So, 2 pi r by t into t by 2. So, answer is pi r. Now, do you understand that this displacement is equals to pi r? Why? Is it clear? I have given you the explanation here. Okay. I hope it is clear now. Suppose if you want, I can explain you once again. I can take this speech. Suppose, see, what I am saying is V equals to R omega for pure rolling. Omega is how much? 2 pi upon time period. So V will be 2 pi R upon time period. Now this center is moving with velocity V. This is moving with 2V and this is 0 for pure rolling. We all know that. So when after what time, capital T by 2, half the revolution means half the time taken, half the time period, right? So this distance is delta x covered by the center. So we will say delta x is equals to V into time is half. So 2 pi r by capital T into T by 2 will be what? Pi r. Got it? So this is the distance traveled. So where is the point A now? Pure rotation is happening. A has gone here. So we can say this distance is delta x. This is 2 r. and this is the overall displacement. Got it? Fantastic. Now, the position of the particle moving in the xy plane. Okay. So first we will say dx by dt. This is what vx, that means x component of velocity, and this is equal to 6t minus 6. So this will be 6 into t minus 1. Got it? Number one. Number two, what is dy by dt here? You will say, sir, dy by dt is equal to vy, which will be 2t minus 2. So vy is equals to 2 into t minus 1. Got it? Okay, so they are asking the velocity of the particle is 0 at t equals to 1. Obviously, see, if you put t equals to 1, if you put t equals to 1 seconds, you can see that vx is also coming out to be 0 and vy is also coming out to be 0. Clear? So third option is correct. Now, acceleration of a projectile relative to another projectile is obviously 0. Why? Because ay is minus g for both the projectiles. Right, so a1 you will say minus g, a2 you will say minus g, so delta a will be what? 0. Relative acceleration is 0. Centripetal force required by a 100 kg car that takes a turn of radius 50 meter and the speed. Okay, fine. Centripetal force will be mv square by r. Now just be careful, v is 36 kmph converted into meter per second, 5 by 18, that is 10 meter per second. You know this already. 1 kilometer per hour is always equals to 5 by 18 meters per second. So this is how we convert. Now we know everything. So force will be what? 1000 into 10 whole square by 50. 50 ones are, 50 twenties are. Answer is 2000 Newton. Got it? 19th question. So they are saying that this is a cylinder. Okay, a block of mass 10 kg is in contact against the inner wall with a hollow cylinder. Okay, this is a block which is in contact here. So what will happen? This cylinder is rotating with certain angular speed omega. They are saying the minimum angular velocity needed for the cylinder to keep the block stationary when the cylinder is vertical and rotating about its own axis. See, if I draw the FPD of this block, obviously, because of rotation, it will try to move outwards. So there will be a normal force here. This normal is going to provide the necessary centripetal acceleration. But because of mg, this wants to go down. So hence, friction will come into action to prevent it from slipping. Right? So you will say, sir, FL will be equals to mu into n. And n is providing the necessary centripetal acceleration, that is m omega square r. Okay, so you can say summation of fy must be 0 because the block is not slipping. So you will say mu m omega square r is equals to mg. So mass is cancelled out. So from here, omega square will be g by mu r. Okay, from here, if you solve, you will definitely get the answer 10. Got it? So finally, you will say omega is root over g by mu r. Now you can put the values. G is 10, r is 1, mu is 0.1. So obviously, you can say numerator will become 100 and omega is 10. Okay, first option is right. Clear? Second option, second question. 20th question. A stone of mass tied to end of the string length, it whirl in vertical to the maximum tension string is the velocity of the top is. Okay. See, maximum tension appears only at the bottommost point. Right? So, at the bottommost point, let's find out the velocity first of all. Let's say it is V1. So, you will say, sir, at the bottommost point, it is mg downward, tension T upward. Definitely, centripetal acceleration is upward. So we will say T minus mg is equals to mac. So you will say, sir, tension T equals to mg plus mv square by r, mv1 square by r. Got it? So this is how you get the value of tension T. right? Okay, so this point is understood. Just hang on a minute, students. Okay, students, okay. One second. Just 1 minute. Yes, perfect. So this is how we are gonna find out t equals to mg plus mv1 square by r. Okay, so from here we will get the information of v1, right? So this is equation number one. Now what they want is the velocity at the top. See, at the topmost point, then you will use energy conservation. Now you will say, when the object is here and it goes to the topmost point, let's say its velocity is v2. Okay, let's say its velocity is v2, here it is v1. So it has been taken to a height of 2r. Can you see that? So from here we can see that half m v1 square, that is kinetic energy at the bottom, is mg into h, potential energy at the topmost point, plus half m v2 square, right? So from here what we can do is a very smartly we can solve. I can say that mv1 square is equals to 2mg into 2r plus mv2 square, right? Now mv1 square is t minus mg into r is equals to 4mg into r plus mv2 square. Now I can see that you can put the values and directly get the value of v2 from here. Okay, now put the value of tension, mass and everything, and from here you can get the value of v2 easily. Do you understand? So this way it will become easy and definitely you will get this answer 2.2. I have solved it. You can also solve and get the answer, no problem. Okay, now again, a mass of 0.1 kg is rotated in a vertical circle using a string of length 20 centimeter. See, doesn't matter. Suppose if the object is rotating like this at any angle theta. So you will say, sir, this is mg, and this mg is gonna have two components. We already know that. What are those two components? One is this in this direction, another one will be in this direction. Okay, now the thing is, this is mg cos theta. So mg cos theta and tension, they are together providing centripetal acceleration. T minus mg cos theta is equals to m into ac, right? So tension T is mg cos theta plus mv square by r. This is the use of mg cos theta. But at the same time, mg sin theta is also acting, and we rarely discuss about it. It is providing the tangential acceleration. Okay, so we will say mg sin theta is actually providing the tangential acceleration. So from here you can say tangential acceleration is g sin theta. Now you can put the values and get the answer. Okay, sin theta sin 30 is half, g by 2 is 4.9. so answer is first option. Got it? 20 second. A bob of mass 100 grams tied at the end of a string. Okay. Again, just now we have derived this formula. Can you see this? This is the formula for tension at any angle theta. So I can say tension T is mg cos theta plus mv square by r. We can say this, right? Now you just put the values. Tension is 0.7. Mass is 0.1. 0.1 into g is 10. Mass is why 0.1? Because it is 100 grams and we need to convert it into kg. So 0.1 kg into cos theta plus mv square by r. 0.1 into 1 square by r is 0.5. Again 0.5. Why I am saying 0.5? Because it is 50 centimeter. You need to convert it into meter, right? So it is 1 by 5. That is 0.2. So it will become 0.7 is equals to cos theta plus 0.2. So it will become 0.5 is equals to cos theta, which means theta is 60 degrees because cos 60 is half. Got it? Yes or no? This is the formula for tension in general. I have already derived it here. Can you see that? Okay. Now, a simple pendulum of length L carries a bob of mass M. If the breaking strength of the string is 2 MD, the maximum angular amplitude from the vertical can be. See, the thing is, breaking will happen when the tension is maximum. Tension is maximum at the lowermost point. Suppose you have taken it to a height h and then you have released it. So here velocity is 0. When it will pass this point, it will have velocity v. But since it is moving in the circular path, it will definitely have tangential acceleration. So we will say that tension T upward, mg downward. So you will say, sir, T minus mg is equals to m into ac. So tension T is mg plus mv square by r. This is the maximum tension possible, equation number 1. Right? So this part is done, I guess. Now let's move on to the second part of the question, that how to find out v. Now you will say, sir, energy lost here. Kinetic energy 0 plus potential energy is mgh at this point. At bottom, potential energy is 0 but kinetic energy is half mv square. Right? So from here we can say that mv square is equals to 2mgh. And mv square by r will be 2mgh by r. Okay, so this is equation number 2. Now we can put equation number 2 back in equation number 1 and say that tension T is mg plus 2mgh upon r, right? So this is your equation number 3. Now carefully see, what is h? So I'll just quickly solve it for you. Okay, this is r, this is r, this is theta. So what is this height? Is it cos r cos theta? Yes or no? So, and what is this small h? So you can say, sir, r cos theta plus h is equals to r. So h is equals to r into 1 minus cos theta. Now this is your equation number 4. Got it? Now put the value of h in equation number 3 and then you put tension as 2mg and solve. You will definitely get the answer. Cos theta will come out to be half, from where you can say theta is 60 degrees. Okay, I don't have enough space here, so I cannot solve it here, but I hope you understand. And in case you really want, see, just I'll take a minute. T equals to mg plus 2mg h by r. H is what? R into 1 minus cos theta, right, upon r. R is r and r got cancelled. So it is what, 2mg, maximum tension is 2mg plus 2mg minus 2mg cos theta. Now this will get cancelled, right? So you can say 2mg cos theta is equals to mg. So cos theta is half and theta is 60 degrees. Got it? Clear? Now let's move ahead. 24. Two equal masses M and M, they are separated by a distance D. What is the force of attraction? Gm square by D square. Okay. Now if one unit of mass is subtracted from one, and that same unit of mass is added to another mass, so now the force will become F dash, which will be G into M minus 1 into M plus 1 upon D square. So it will be how much? You can say, sir, G by D square into M square minus 1. So we can say F dash is G m square by d square minus g by d square. So we can say f dash is equals to f minus g by d square. So f minus f dash is g by d square. So obviously force has decreased by g by d square. Okay. When a planet moves around the sun, its angular momentum remains constant. It moves faster when it's near to the sun. Absolutely right. टोटल एनर्जी इज कॉन्स्टेंट बट इट इज सेइंग इंक्रीजेज नियर द सन. पोटेंशियल एनर्जी डिक्रीजेस व्हेन इट गोज नियर टू द सन. यस, ए बी डी आर करेक्ट. नाउ हाउ? सी, दिस इज सेकेंड लॉ ऑफ केपलर. एंगुलर मोमेंटम इज कॉन्स्टेंट. दैट मीन्स सी केपलर सेज दैट डी ए बाई डी टी एरियल वेलोसिटी इज एल बाई टू एम एंड इट इज कॉन्स्टेंट. सो एल दैट मीन्स एल इज वॉट एम वी आर. सो एंगुलर मोमेंटम इज कॉन्स्टेंट. एनी वेज इफ यू टॉक अबाउट सन एंड अर्थ द ग्रेविटेशनल फोर्स इज ऑलवेज पासिंग थ्रू द सेंटर ऑफ द सन. दैट इज वाई इफ द फोर्स इज पासिंग थ्रू द सेंटर टॉर्क इज जीरो एंड इफ देर इज नो टॉर्क देन एंगुलर मोमेंटम इज कॉन्स्टेंट. इफ देर इज नो एक्सटर्नल टॉर्क एंगुलर मोमेंटम इज कॉन्स्टेंट. इट मूव्स फास्टर जस्ट बिकॉज ऑफ द फर्स्ट रूल ओनली. सी एम वी आर इज कॉन्स्टेंट. दैट मीन्स वी वन आर वन इज इक्वल्स टू वी टू आर टू. So we can say that if R is lesser, V is more. So near the sun, speed is more. Now what about potential energy? Potential energy formula is minus Gm by R. So if R reduces, Gm by R fraction increases. But since it is a negative sign, so overall it is decreasing. Okay? Clear everyone? So that is why, since minus gm by small r reduces, if small r reduces, gm by r fraction increases, but since it is a negative sign outside, so overall minus gm by r reduces. So a, b and d. Okay, now this is frequency of the particle performing SHM is 12 hertz. What is omega? It is 2 pi f. So omega will be 24 pi hertz or radians per second, right? We can say per second. 24 pi per second. Now initial displacement amplitude is given 4 cm. Initial displacement x naught is given 2 cm. Its equation of displacement is very simple. Let's say x is equals to a sine omega t plus phi. So x is equals to a by 2 when time is 0, that means initially. So from here we can say half is equals to sine of phi. So phi is technically 30 degrees. So equation is 4 sine 24 pi t plus pi by 6 centimeter. Got it? Third option is correct. The time period of a simple pendulum is T when the length increases. See, what is time period? 2 pi root over L by G. So we can say L is equals to G upon 4 pi square. G square upon 4 pi square into T square. So L is directly proportional to T square. So we can say that L is equals to kt square, just a constant, right? Now they are saying if when the length increases by 10 cm, L plus 10 is k into t1 square, and when length decreases by 10 cm, it is k into t2 square. So if you add equation 1 and equation 2, then you will say 2L is equals to k times t1 square plus t2 square. Now L is kt square is equals to k into t1 square plus t2 square. This will get cancelled. So we can say 2t square is t1 square plus t2 square. Third option is correct. Got it? 28. Two simple harmonic oscillators with amplitudes are in the ratio are having the same total energy. See, total energy is half m omega square a square. If they are having same total energy, that means half m omega 1 square a 1 square is equals to half m omega 2 square a 2 square. So it will become omega 1 square dot a 1 square is equals to omega 2 square dot a 2 square. Okay. Now I guess amplitudes are in the ratio 1 is to 2. So 1 upon 4 is equals to omega 1 square is equals to omega 2 square. From here you can say omega 1 by omega 2 is 2 is to 1. Okay students, I hope this point is pretty much clear to all of you. Okay, so let's move ahead and do question number 29. A particle does uniform circular motion in a horizontal plane. The radius of the circle is given. The centripetal force acting on the particle is 10 Newton. Its kinetic energy is. See simply, mv square by r is given to you as F. What is kinetic energy? Half mv square, they are asking. So it will be half into F into R. That's all. They've given every information. What is F? 10 Newton. What is radius? 20 centimeter. So what will happen? Answer will be 1 joules. Okay. Now here, there are 2-3 concepts which are used here. Whenever two objects of same mass collide elastically, then their velocities are interchanged. Suppose this is u1 and this is u2. So after collision, it will move with u2 and it will move with u1. Do you understand? So technically, if a ball is coming with a velocity v and it is at rest, suppose this is ball A, this is ball B. After collision, A will be at rest and B will move with V if they have same mass and they are colliding elastically. Now, second concept is, this is first concept. Second concept is, if you want any object to completely cover this loop, then its velocity at the bottom must be root 5gr. Now we will use the energy conservation and say that mg into h must be equal to half mv square, which is half m into 5gr. So the answer is mg gets cancelled. H is equals to 5/2r. That's all. So if you throw this object A from this height, it will go here with velocity v, and after collision, this is ball A, this is ball B. After collision, A will stop and B will go with root 5gr. Okay, so answer is this. Now second is, a man can swim with a speed of 4 km per hour in still water. Okay, so if a man can swim in still water with 4 km per hour, what is the width of the river? 1 km. Got it. So man is swimming perpendicular to the river flow. River is this. So velocity of river is 3 km per hour. Velocity of man is 4 km per hour. Okay. If he makes his strokes normal to the river current, how far down? Okay. So obviously he is gonna swim like this ultimately because of the river flow. So he is not gonna land at point A. Instead, he is gonna land at point B, and this is the drift. What is the formula of the drift? Drift is, in this case, the drift will be horizontal speed, that is u, because velocity, see, we know that velocity of man with respect to river is velocity of man minus velocity of river. What is velocity of man? It is velocity of man with respect to river plus velocity of river, right? So velocity of man will be, velocity of man with respect to river is 4 j cap plus velocity of river is 3 I cap. Got it? Now, we will say time to cross the river is width of the river upon y component. So, time to cross the river into the horizontal component will give you the drift. Right? So, d is what? 1. Vx is what? 3. Vy is what? 4. Answer is 3/4 km or 750 meters. Simple concept, simple question, simple solution. 32. An automobile of, okay, convex. So an object is going from here with a velocity v. So its center of curvature must be here. So centripetal acceleration must be in this direction. This is mg. This is normal, right? So you can say, sir, mg minus normal is equals to mac. So normal is equals to mg minus mv square by r. Got it? So second option is correct. A small object placed on a rotating horizontal turntable just slips when it is placed at a distance 4 cm from the axis of rotation. If the angular velocity is doubled, see, if it just slips from certain point r, suppose if it just slips, so we will say that on this object, this is normal, this is mg, here is the centripetal acceleration. So who is going to provide it? The friction. So you will say, sir, FL is going to provide the necessary centripetal acceleration. What is FL? M into omega square r. Now the value of FL is fixed, that is mu mg. It is m omega square r. So you can say mu g is equals to omega square r. Now the value of mu and g is fixed for the object. So if you increase the omega, that means we can say omega square r is constant. So if you increase omega, r has to be reduced. So you can say omega 1 square r1 must be equal to omega 2 square r2. Right? Now they are saying that angular velocity of the turntable is doubled. So if this is omega, this is 2 omega. So we can say r2 is r by 4. R1 by 4. And r1 is 4 centimeter. So 4 centimeter by 4, I guess r2 will be 1 centimeter. Got it? Now a person walks at the rate of 3 kilometer. Okay, a person walks at the rate of 3 kilometer per hour. Right? Fine. So velocity of the man is given to us. It is 3 I cap. Rain comes at him. Velocity of rain with respect to the man is vertically downwards. 3 root 3 times minus J cap. Simple law. Velocity of rain with respect to the man is velocity of rain minus velocity of man. So what is velocity of rain? It is velocity of rain with respect to man plus velocity of man. Simple, just simple addition. So we can say velocity of man plus velocity of rain with respect to man is gonna give you velocity of rain. This is the angle with the vertical theta, right? So from here, velocity of rain will become 3 I cap plus 3 root 3 minus J cap. So from here you can say velocity of rain magnitude wise will become how much? Can you tell me? 3 square plus 3 root 3 whole square. Right? So it will become 6 kilometer per hour. You can do it, right? Okay, and what is theta? So from here you can say, sir, tan theta is equals to Vm upon V of r with respect to m. So tan theta will be 3 upon 3 root 3. Right? So tan theta is 1 by root 3. So theta is 30 degrees. So answer is 6 kilometer per hour inclined at an angle 30 degree to the vertical. Do you understand, students? I hope these solutions you are able to understand and learn from it, right? Okay, in case in any question you feel any doubt or you want anything, any concept you want to discuss, the comment section will be open for all of you. You can write your views or write your doubts in the comment section, okay? A string of length capital L is fixed at one end and carries a mass capital M at the other end. The string makes 2 by pi revolutions per second. 2 by pi revolutions per second. So omega is what? 2 by pi revolutions. So into 2 pi radians per second. Okay. So this is 4 radians per second. Got it? This is one thing. Now the tension in the string is, tension in the string is very simple, very simple. You will say, sir, this is tension T, this is mg. Tension T will have components, right? This is theta. So here it is accelerated also. So you will say T's sine component is providing m omega square into radius r. Right, answer is not given in terms of r, answer is given in terms of l. Okay, got it. What is sine theta? Sine theta is r upon l. So tension T into r by l is m into 4 whole square into r. I guess tension is 16 ml. Got it? Very simple. See, this is T cos theta. T cos theta is balancing mg. And T sine theta is providing the necessary centripetal acceleration. Got it? Here again, this is balanced by the tension. Small mg is balanced by the tension in the rope. And here the tension in the rope is providing the necessary centripetal acceleration. So T is providing capital M into omega square into L. And this T is also balancing small mg. So we can say capital M omega square L is equals to small mg. So what they are asking is small m. Small m is nothing but capital M L omega square by g. Got it? A particle originally at rest at the highest point of a smooth vertical circle is slightly displaced. It will leave the circle at a distance h below. Okay, very simple. Let's say a particle is kept here. When it leaves the circle, that means normal is zero. The contact is going away. The contact is going away. That means the normal will become zero here. So you will say, sir, right now, let's say the point comes down by a height h. Okay, this is theta. And it is leaving. That means here at this point normal is zero. So first of all, let's find out h. Very simple. This complete distance is r. This is r. Now this is h. And if this is theta, this is r cos theta. Right? So you can clearly see and say that, sir, h plus r cos theta is equals to capital R, right? So from here we can say that, sir, h is equals to r into 1 minus cos theta. Now we will use energy conservation in between these two points, A and B. So you will say, sir, kinetic energy is 0 plus potential energy is mgh. Here let's say the kinetic energy is half mv square, but potential energy will be 0. So all the potential energy lost is converted into kinetic energy, right? So mv square is equals to 2mgh. Now we will say this is equation number 1. This is equation number 2. Now let's draw the FBD of this object. See, if I draw the FBD here, you will say, sir, mg is acting here. This angle is theta. This angle is theta. This is normal and this is mg cos theta. What is this component? Mg cos theta. So mg cos theta and normal are providing the necessary centripetal acceleration. So you will say, sir, mg cos theta minus normal is mv square by r. Since it is losing contact there, the normal should be 0. So you will say, sir, mg cos theta must be equal to mv square by r as the normal is 0. Right? So this is your third equation. Now mv square is 2mgh. We can write here mv square is 2 mgh, right? And we can say that mv square by r is mg cos theta. So we can say mv square is 2mgh by r is equals to mg cos theta, right? Now mg and mg will get cancelled. So 2h is equals to r cos theta. Got it? Now you will say, sir, h is equals to r into 1 minus cos theta is equals to r cos theta. R and r gets cancelled. 2 minus 2 cos theta is equals to cos theta. So 2 is equals to 3 cos theta. So cos theta is equals to 2 by 3. Now still the question is not over. What is h? H is r into 1 minus cos theta. So h is equals to r into 1 minus 2 by 3. So h is equals to r by 3. I hope you understood it now. Okay, clear everyone? Sure. Now let's move ahead and do question number 38. Question number 38. Four particles of mass m, 2m, 3m, and 4m are kept. See, m, 2m, 3m. 4m. Now at this point they want to find out the gravitational force. It's very simple, students. See, I can reduce that. See, the gravitational force or field at this point by every point mass will be in this direction. Can I reduce this diagram? See, this is 2m and this is 4m. So technically it is only 2m in this direction. This is m and this is 3m. If we cancel out the fields, it is only 2m in this direction. That is what is left here in this diagram. Can I reduce this diagram like this? And I can say there are only two equal gravitational fields at an angle 90 degrees. Now can I find out gravitational field E here and E here. What is the formula for gravitational field? G into mass upon distance square, R square. What is this R? R means half of the diagonal. Half of the diagonal is L by root C. If I say this is a square, this is diagonal. If this is A, this is root 2A. So R will be root 2A by 2. That is A by root 2. Okay, A by root 2. So G into 2m upon A by root 2 whole square. So gravitational field due to single 2m here will be 4gm by A square. Now, this is not the right answer, right? 4gm by A square is not the correct answer. Just wait. These are two electric fields or two gravitational fields acting at an angle 90 degrees. Two gravitational fields which are equal in magnitude acting at an angle 90 degrees. How to solve? Then you will say, sir, whenever two vectors of equal magnitude act at an angle 90 degrees, then the resultant is root 2 times the individual magnitude, right? So you will say E net will be root 2 E, which is 4 root 2 gm by A square. So this is the best way to solve it, right? You can simply reduce E 4m and 2m opposite. So their fields will cancel. So it will remain only the field of 2m. Here 3m and m, they will cancel out. Some part of the m is cancelled out. So it will be effectively 2m only remaining in this direction. Okay. 39. Assume that acceleration due to gravity on the surface of moon is 0.2 times the acceleration due to gravity on the surface of earth. The range of projectile is u square sine 2 theta by g. So basically r is inversely proportional to g. right? So R1 by R2 is equals to G2 by G1. Now they are saying G2 is 0.2 times G1. It is 0.2. So R2 will be R1 by 0.2. That is 5R1. So range on the moon is 5 times the range on Earth. A plane is flying horizontally at 98 meter per second. 98 meter per second means 10 g. And releases an object which reaches the ground in 10 seconds. Okay. Let's say it leaves the object from height h with a speed u. It will come like this and fall. So what they are asking is the angle made by the object when it hits the ground. Okay. Like this. So this is what? This is u. This is theta. And this is root 2 gh if you remember. Right. Now they are saying that it reaches the ground in 10 seconds. Or we can say this is theta. This is Vx and this is Vy, right? Now let's begin. Vx always remain equal to u only, which is 10 times g. Vy is equals to uy plus ay into t. Now uy is 0 because it is dropped vertically. Ay is what? Ay is minus g into 10 times 10. Okay, so it is minus 10 g. So when you look at this triangle, this is Vx, this is Vy, this is V, this is theta. So tan theta is equals to Vy upon Vx. What is Vy? 10 g upon 10 g. That is 1. So theta is 45 degrees. Got it? Now, do you know the formula of equation of trajectory? It is It is x tan theta minus g upon 2 u square cos square theta into x square. Got it? So if you do the comparison, then you can say tan theta is root 3. Theta is 60 degrees. Apart from that, 2 u square cos square theta is equals to 2. If you just do the comparison, I'm saying cos 60 is okay. So you will say u square is equals to 4. U is equals to 2 meter per second. Got it? So first option is correct. Vector u is given ai cap plus bj cap plus ck cap. Okay, the maximum height of the projectile is. Simple. The height of the projectile depends upon the vertical velocity. So it is Vy square upon 2g. And what is Vy? Vy is c because vertical direction is c. C square by 2g. Third option is correct. That's all. Two cliffs of height 120 meter and 100.4 are separated by a horizontal distance 16 meter. If the car has to reach from the first cliff to the second, the horizontal velocity should be. Two cliffs, okay, this is 120 meter. Another cliff is 100.4 meter. Okay, what is the gap here? 19.6 meter. Separated by a horizontal distance 16 meter. Okay, if the car has to reach from the first cliff to the second, the horizontal velocity of the car should be. Okay, so this is the car. It is doing a kind of a stunt. And the car has to just reach here. Okay. That means this is H, this is R. So height is given 19.6 meters. I suppose it is 2G. Range is what? Range is U into time of flight. It is U into root over 2H by G. Now you tell me H is 2G. So 2 into 2g upon g under root will become 2u. So range is 2 times u. So u is nothing but range by 2. Range is 16. 16 by 2 is nothing but 8 meters per second. Got it? Okay, so this concept is clear. Oh, a ball is thrown with a velocity of u making an angle theta with the horizontal. Its velocity after normal to initial vector. Okay, fine. They are asking, suppose this, okay, and there is an object which is thrown, okay, like this. Suppose this is the line of motion right now. Okay. What they are saying is that it will go like this, right? So after what time the velocity will become perpendicular to it? Okay, can you see this? This is 90 degrees. So this is vector u, this is theta, and this is vector v. Got it? Now what they are asking is its velocity vector after time interval. So if you want, you can just remember this answer. First thing, there are many possible ways in which you can solve this question. I will give you a very different kind of a view this time. Okay. Because there are many kind of solutions available everywhere, but I have one solution of my own, and I'll tell you that. See, first you can remember this answer. In this is a special case, you can remember u by g sine theta. Otherwise, there's a special method to solve it. What I can do is I can say, first one thing I just want to ask. Suppose if an object is thrown with a velocity u, acceleration is g downward. In how much time it reaches the topmost point? Topmost point, that means its velocity becomes zero in this direction, right? So you will say, sir, time is very simple to find out. V is equals to u minus gt, and t is equals to, so put v equals to zero, u minus gt, and time is u by g. Yes or no? What is the time period? Time is u by g. That means when time is u by g, it reaches the topmost point, right? And the time is u by g, it reaches the topmost point. That you know very well. Now I have a very brilliant method. What I can do is just look very carefully, right, students? Let's see here. Suppose this is g acting right now. G is acting like this. This g will have two components. One will be here, and one will be perpendicular to the initial velocity, right? If this is theta, this is 90 minus theta, so this is theta. So this is g cos theta, and this is g sine theta. Can you see that? Now, if you look of the motion along this axis, x dash, if this axis, if you look, this is the point. If the velocity has become perpendicular, that means there is no velocity in this direction along xx dash. That means this is the topmost point for this axis. This is the topmost point for this axis. So what is the time taken to reach the topmost point? U by, now what is g? Instead of g, what is the downward acceleration? G sine theta. So your answer is u by g sine theta. I hope you understood this method, and are you getting what I'm saying? I'm saying that In this direction, initial velocity is u. If the velocity becomes perpendicular, it simply means that the velocity in this direction has become zero, right? In this direction, there is no more any velocity. So this is zero, right? So technically, this is the topmost point for this axis, the red one, this axis. If this is the topmost point, what is the time taken to reach the topmost point? U upon downward acceleration. But what is the downward acceleration this time? It is g sine theta. So it's not u by g, it is u by g sine theta. So this is how we can get the answer. One more method I'm telling you. Okay. 45. The bob of a simple pendulum. See what happens when you fill it with water. So right now, when the water is completely filled, the center of mass is here. But as the water keeps on moving, as the water starts leaking, the water level falls, the center of mass also starts falling. So length, effective length also starts increasing. So length starts increasing, time period starts increasing. But when the complete water has gone, the center of mass again comes back to the same position. So what happened? First it increases and then again decreases to original value. Okay. See, at the lowest point, what is the tension? At the highest point, the tension is zero, right? Here the velocity is root 5gr. Okay. Here the tension is zero. T1, T2. So we will say T1 is equals to mg plus mv square by r. This time I will not tell you the derivation because in many questions I have already done it for you. So mg plus m into 5gr by r. So T1 is 6mg, T2 is 0, so the difference is 6mg. Got it? 7. A particle p is moving in a circle of radius r with uniform speed v if ab is the diameter. Okay, this is a very nice question. See, we have to analyze the object from two frames. Okay, now listen, if this angle is theta, this angle is alpha, so this is also alpha, and theta is 2 alpha, so alpha is theta by 2. Now just listen to me very carefully. This is point A, this is point C, this is point B. Omega with respect to C is nothing but d theta by dt, and omega with respect to A is nothing but d alpha by dt, rate of change of angle alpha. Alpha is theta by 2, so it is 1 by 2 d theta by dt. So it is omega c by 2. So if they want the ratio of omega A upon omega C, answer will be 1:2. Got it? See, the point is rotating like this. If it is rotating, with respect to C, theta is changing. But with respect to A, alpha is changing. Got it? A car is traveling with a minimum between the tires, the minimum turning radius is. See, it's very logical. We all know that mu mg provides the necessary centripetal acceleration. So what they want is minimum turning radius. R will be v square by mu g. V you need to convert into meter per second. So 36 multiplied by 5 by 18 will become 10. So 10 square by 0.5 into 10 will be 20 meters. The time period of oscillation. Do you have, remember this formula that V is equals to omega times root over A square minus X square. So in the above equation, you take out 144, sorry, you take out time period of oscillation, right? You take out 9 common. So it will be 9 into 144 by 9 minus x square. So can you write it like this? 3 square into 12 by 3 whole square minus x square. So it will be 3 square into 4 square minus x square. So when you take under root, so it will be 3 times under root 4 square minus x square. Now can you compare this equation number 2 with this equation number 1? Okay, so omega is 3. Can you see the comparison? Omega is 3. So if omega is 3, omega is 2 pi upon time period, which is 3. So time period is 2 pi upon 3. Got it? Now fourth is, in uniform circular motion, obviously tangential acceleration is 0. That's all. So that is all for today. I hope you have learned a lot from this solution. So keep giving your papers. Don't miss your examination. and keep solving like this. Thank you so much. Tada, bye bye.